Baywatch star Yasmine Bleeth was bathing suit royalty in the 90s, but she's since fallen into obscurity. She's in her 50s now, and she looks very different than she did during her time on the beach. Keep watching to find out what happened to her. During her time on Baywatch, Bleeth was hounded by paparazzi, as stories about her suspected drug use would fill countless tabloid column inches. In 2017, her former co-star Gina Lee Nolan told Cosmopolitan that Bleeth was often treated unfairly by the press. As she put it, "It was absolutely nonstop. She was at the payphone where we filmed, this was before cell phones, and she scratched her nose and the Inquirer had three pictures of her, like front cover, Yasmine Bleeth, there's drugs, or whatever. And at the time, when I knew her, there was none of that going on." Some reports suggest that Bleeth's drug use didn't start until she left Baywatch and joined the cast of the crime drama Nash Bridges. But according to Baywatch producer Douglas Schwartz, she had substance problems while she was on Baywatch as well. In 2012, he told Esquire, "That's why we let Yasmine go off the show, because it was too difficult to deal with her after a while." Esquire also talked with Tracy Bingham, who wasn't exactly sympathetic with her co-star's plight. As she said, "Yasmine Bleeth and the whole cocaine thing, who does that, really? To the point where she's so out of the business now, completely MIA." The way Yasmine Bleeth tells it, she wasn't fired from Baywatch, she simply took up another offer when her contract ran out. That offer was the role of San Francisco PD Inspector Caitlin Cross on Nash Bridges, and according to her, that's when her cocaine habit exploded. She was dating fellow actor Richard Grieco at the time, and the long distance between them quickly exposed cracks in their relationship. Out of desperation, she turned to cocaine. As she told Glamour in 2003, "I just wanted to feel good again, and I knew an easy way to get that feeling." For a while, Bleeth was just a casual user, but things took a turn for the worse after she started using when she was home by herself. Her addiction then spiraled out of control and began to take a toll on her physical appearance. She told Glamour, "By the end of 1999, I'd stopped looking like myself. I'm a fleshy girl, very curvy and round, but I'd lost my softness. My friend said I looked like an alien, that my eyes were bulging out of my face. I wasn't anorexic looking, but instead of being a size 6 with a 29-inch waist, I was 110 pounds and a size 0. Bleeth has claimed that she never took drugs while on the job, but she couldn't deny that her addiction had a major impact on her career. She told Glamour, "Because I was doing them until 6 a.m., I'd still be high during the day. Sometimes I'd be so exhausted that I'd fall asleep in my trailer and someone would have to come get me." Why didn't her colleagues see the red flags? According to Bleeth, they did, but they ignored them. As she revealed to Glamour, "I got a bloody nose on the set a couple of times, but the makeup artist would just hand me a tissue without saying a word and I'd clean it up." Bleeth's constant cocaine-related sniffing was in danger of exposing her habits, so her publicist would exploit the fact that she had some prior sinus problems and say that she had an allergic reaction. In 2001, a source from Nash Bridges told People magazine, "They were showing less of her full face. There's only so much makeup can do. Everyone knew she had a drug problem." Bleeth finally decided it was time to kick her habit when she was confronted by her father after he found a bag of cocaine in her purse. She initially rejected his help and avoided him for months while she finished shooting her last season of Nash Bridges. She then returned to Los Angeles, where her dad was waiting for her at the airport. As she recalled to Glamour, "He took one look at me and started to cry. Seeing the expression on my father's face and knowing his heart was being ripped out of his body, that was the first time I was truly confronted by how I was affecting other people." Her father begged her to let him help, and she agreed. He took her to a doctor, who told her that she had been playing a dangerous game. She had a dime-sized hole in her septum, as well as an infection that had left her nose raw and bloody. The doctor told her that if the infection had gone untreated, it could have progressed to her brain and killed her. Looking back at that moment, Bleeth said, "That scared me. At least until I started doing drugs again 6 weeks later." In the fall of 2000, Bleeth was starring in the NBC primetime soap opera Titans. In September of that year, she was at a photo shoot for the show. Her cocaine use had left her so weak that the breeze from a fan caused her to collapse. A friend then came to collect her and drive her home. She put Bleeth to bed and then left, but not before relieving her of a few items. As she recalled to Glamour, "When I woke up, my car keys were gone and my wallet was missing. When I looked in the drawer where I usually keep my drugs, I found only a note that said, 'I'm the cocaine Robin Hood. I took your cocaine and gave it to someone who really needed it, the toilet.' I still have that note." It wasn't until a month after her visit from the cocaine Robin Hood that Bleeth got the motivation she needed. Two friends showed up to offer some support, and their words deeply affected the struggling actor. According to Bleeth, they just said, "We really miss you. We're there for you, and this is really hurting us. I'd already been confronted by my father. I didn't want to be confronted by them, too." It was the fear of disappointing her friends that ultimately made Bleeth take the idea of rehab seriously. Her father, managed to convince Titans producers to give her the time off, and she entered the Promises Clinic in Malibu, California. Bleeth was given an extra 2 weeks off after her Christmas break from Titans, which gave her enough time to complete a month in rehab. She was still using drugs in the car on the way there, but she ultimately found the experience easier than expected. As she told Glamour, "Rehab was easy. There were only about 12 of us there, and I had a single room. We were on a tight schedule, up at 7 o'clock every morning doing chores like cleaning the kitchen or bathroom, then attending individual and group counseling sessions." Bleeth didn't enter rehab with romance on her mind, but by the time she left Promises, she was deeply in love. In her first few days there, she met strip club owner Paul Cerrito, and it was love at first sight. Starting a relationship with another program participant was frowned upon, but Bleeth knew that she had found the one. As she put it, "Nothing used to make me feel as good as cocaine until I fell in love. Now the feeling I have when I'm with Paul is better than how I felt on cocaine." The happy couple eventually made things official at a low-key wedding in 2002. On September 11, 2001, Bleeth and Cerrito were due to fly from Detroit, Michigan to Los Angeles. But when the airports closed due to the terrorist attacks of that day, the couple made a bad decision as they bought some drugs and checked into a hotel. The following evening, Bleeth was still high when the two of them got into their rental car. She lost control of the vehicle and slammed into the median, and before she knew it, there were several cops and an ambulance on the scene. What happened next was a moment that Bleeth will never forget. Police found four syringes containing what appeared to be liquid cocaine in her purse. She confirmed that she was high and then acted incredulously when she was arrested. As she put it to Glamour, "I remember saying, 'But I didn't hurt anybody. You're arresting me?' Then it occurred to me, 'Oh, that's right, drugs are illegal.' That's the scary thing. I'd really forgotten that what I was doing was illegal." The accident made Bleeth and Cerrito reevaluate things and ultimately saved their relationship. As she put it, "The only reason Paul and I are together today is because we had some divine intervention, our accident." Bleeth made a number of film appearances in the late 90s as she attempted to parlay her TV stardom into big-screen success. Unfortunately, though, the performances she turned in didn't really impress the critics, and they absolutely hated one in particular. Her turn as Trey Parker's love interest in the 1998 comedy BASEketball was widely derided. She was even nominated in the Worst Actress category at the Golden Raspberry Awards, though she did lose to all of the Spice Girls for Spice World. Her career stalled when Titans was canceled after season 1, and before long, she became a bit of a ghost. She was working on a horror movie called Beautiful Evil at one point, but that never saw the light of day. Her most recent credit listed on IMDb is the 2003 TV movie Baywatch Hawaiian Wedding. It's unclear whether she left Hollywood to recover, or if the roles simply dried up as a result of her personal woes, or both. It's a tough business, and considering everything she's been through, the fact that she's no longer landing roles shouldn't be too surprising. At the height of her fame, Yasmine Bleeth wasn't exactly on track to win an Oscar, but she was the type of celebrity who women wanted to be and men wanted to be with.
Is there a guy in your life right now? Is there anything that you can talk about on the air?
I'm still waiting, Conan.
But even if her career hadn't been derailed by drugs, there's no guarantee that she would be busy working, as there aren't exactly a huge variety of roles for middle-aged women in Hollywood. The former bombshell looks more like someone's friendly mom these days, and there's plenty of paparazzi shots to prove it. In January 2015, Bleeth made a public appearance at the 55th annual Penguin Plunge in Venice Beach. That marked the first time that she'd been photographed by the paparazzi since she attended Carmen Electra and Dave Navarro's engagement party back in 2003. She's been seen on just a handful of occasions since then. Sometimes she's with her husband, and sometimes while walking her dog. As anyone who struggled with drug addiction will tell you, recovery is a lifelong battle. For Yasmine Bleeth, she's been able to avoid backsliding by indulging in the simple things in life. As she confessed to Glamour, "I'm enjoying being social, sleeping in, curling up in a big down comforter. When I was taking drugs, I lost my love for all that."
You're Yasmine Bleeth! How could you not have plans?
I think I'll probably stay at home, cook myself some dinner, and watch that log on TV. You know, that fire log on TV.
She's happy to have found some stability, though staying clean has been a real struggle for her over the years. She finds things like going to clubs difficult because she relates happy feelings to cocaine. But every time that she almost talks herself into using again, she reminds herself of where just one line of cocaine will lead. As she explained, "I mentally walk myself through the entire scenario, the end result of which is me alone in my apartment, not speaking to my friends, not speaking to my family, and probably without my husband." Through all the ups and downs, Bleeth has learned one important lesson. She can't truly experience love when she's under the hold of drugs, according to her. Every day, I have to make the choice again. So far, I choose love. If you or someone you know is struggling with addiction, please call the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Administration's 24/7 National Helpline at 1-800-662-HELP. That's 1-800-662-4357.